Main issue with these belts is they are made very poorly. Let's do some maintenance on it. Take the belt here. This is the belt we need to replace, so take it off of there. A couple of things we can check is these eccentric nuts here. They shouldn't spin freely, which, oh, look, mine one's free, spins freely. Same as this one. So tighten up those two. Underneath the bed, there's a couple of eccentric nuts. See? One, two. Tighten those so that there's no wobble this way. Other one would be to check here as well. The one underneath here. So that there's no wobble on this, which is pretty good. All right, so after we've tightened the eccentric nuts, clear up any of the excess stuff here, and then we're ready to replace our belt. To replace your belt is to loosen off. That'll take off this front cover. Same on this side. There's a screw here and a screw here. Okay, so once you've removed those screws and possibly the one underneath, which is that one for the pooper, come out like this. And what you'll need to do is just undo this all the way so that that pops out so that we can thread the belt through it. Just do the other side. Undone, take that off. And just careful of the wire there and you'll see that's exposed. So that's all we need to do for now, and then we'll just wrap the belt around. Feed the belt through that gap there, goes all the way through, out that side, and then comes back through. Once you've fed it through, slide it onto that, and do the same on this side. Make sure to thread the belt through, and then just leave it hanging there for now. Now that we've got it hooked up, there's your tensioner. We can put the plastic back on and then start the tensioning again. Got some sort of tension on it. Put the screws back in. And at the same time, you can put this one back on now because you can see that's already in place. So we've got a bit of tension on here now. Make sure that it still runs freely, which it does. And yeah, that's basically, you're done with all the maintenance. We'll just need to, I'll just re-grease these up because you can see there's quite a lot of dark oil. Well, using isopropyl, I'll clean it up using isopropyl and then I'll put the grease back on. Check for stress fractures or cracks or anything like that. So along here, because this is all plastic, this is plastic, this is plastic, this part is plastic and this is plastic. So for vibration, best is just check for anything loose. Nothing's loose there. Nothing's loose there, nothing's cracked or wobbly. Here's another issue, is if your Z height is really high on one side and really low on another, like that, for example. And see, really high, it goes back over there, and it's really low. If that's the case, what we need to do is you just take these two off, undo these two nuts on here, take this off, take the top off, which is this one, obviously move it up and down, pop something underneath on one side, pop something underneath on the other side to make sure it's square. It's close enough where that the millimeters that it needs to adjust, if you just check through there, it's a very small difference between there and there. So we should be good from side to side. In case you don't believe me, there's the head on this side. And we just push them across. Still, oh my God, this is the worst angle. Still insanely close to the bed. So it's like within a millimeter. Like, yeah, very, very good. That'll do the auto adjust and yeah. Right. Now that it's all back where it should be, get the ace plug. Ace plug. Let's just print something that I printed in the past. Input shaping and labeling with white. To make sure that works. We'll be right back. Still waiting. Still waiting for it to do a purge. Purge line. Oh, look, it's nice and level. I only bought this bed because I like the honeycomb on it. That's why I got two. No, wait. That's why I got three. No, wait. That's why I got four. Yeah.